Battlefront 2 is at a crucial point in its lifespan. The game has been out for almost half a year and has gained one of the worst reputations in gaming. The main focus has been on microtransactions and their negative impact. However, those playing the game can also point to many different gameplay problems and bugs that are still in the game and have not been fixed. The game is in a pretty bad spot and is slowly starting to improve. The problem is that this progress is so slow that some doubt the game will ever reach its fullest potential. Battlefront 2 will continue to limp along unless it receives a major operation to fix its biggest flaws. Will it receive the operation is the question, though. I believe that we will get a better grasp on the future of Battlefront 2 at EA Play. I personally feel that Battlefront may be left to die. This won't be the first time that EA has killed a game off shortly after release, as Mass Effect Andromeda, which was released a little more than half a year before Battlefront 2, met a similar fate. Some of the many problems were addressed, but the game reached a point where it was left in a state of, this is as good as it gets. A lot of bigger problems and additions that the game needed were never included. If we look at Battlefront 2, it kind of feels like deja vu. Battlefront 2 seems to be receiving more fixes and content updates on a more regular basis than Andromeda did, but some of the biggest problems have yet to be addressed. And when there are changes, more problems seem to arise to add onto the pre-existing ones. If microtransactions were left in the game, we would probably have a completely different game with more free content drops. However, since the game is most likely not receiving much revenue past the initial purchases, I assume that the plans for the game are drastically smaller than what was intended. Will this change, though? Will we see the game evolve into something bigger and something that I assume was intended for the game at the start? EA Play will give EA the chance to show that they are listening and have bigger plans for the game. The second half of content for the solo season was just announced. I made a video of it you can see at the top, as well as a mention of the recycled extraction mode being shown at the fan event at EA Play. What is even bigger is that the news article from EA states that we will share an update on what's next for Star Wars Battlefront 2 at the EA Play press conference on June 9. This is a great opportunity for EA to save face by showing a detailed roadmap of the game. If EA is to take this opportunity to admit the problems that are in the game and then to go over changes coming to the game, I think that Battlefront 2 could have a second life, if you will. I guess the next question is, what would be required for Battlefront 2 to be saved? I think that quality of life changes need to be implemented as soon as possible. Balancing and bug fixes need to arrive at a faster rate, in my opinion. I have personally taken a break from the game because of unbalanced heroes and classes. When I encounter additional problems, even smaller ones such as the bug spawn screen on Theed, that just makes me want to play the game even less. Not having a server browser or even a map selector is also another kick in the teeth. After around 40 hours of gameplay, there are still some maps that I have only played once or twice or not even at all, but I have played Theed more times than I would like. I also feel that I want more interesting game modes. As it stands, Ewok Hunt is the most interesting mode for me, and I have already gotten bored with it. It has some great features, but I believe that it still requires some minor changes in order to be perfect and stay fresh, which I discussed in the video at the top if you want to hear what I had to say about that. The standard modes in the game are all pretty boring to me. I also think that the point system is a mess and ruins most gameplay moments, as you are more worried about how many points you earn instead of how much you are helping your team. I feel that more interesting modes akin to Ewok Hunt have a great potential in Battlefront 2, as well as simpler modes such as a Conquest or Capture the Flag type mode, where it is a symmetrical fight rather than an asymmetrical fight. The one mode that we have that features a larger scale battle is still broken up between an attacking team and a defending team. I recently jumped back into Battlefront 2015, and although there were a lot of modes which featured a similar asymmetrical battle, it also featured Supremacy, which saw two teams trying to battle over the same points. It was a great mode which saw even conflict rather than an uneven fight. More diverse modes could help the game. Some of the best content added to Battlefront 2015 was some of the modes such as the dynamic and varied gameplay of Sabotage from the Bespin DLC, Battle Station from the Death Star DLC, or Infiltration from the Rogue One DLC. All of these modes featured really cool and innovative gameplay changes. The main problem with expecting such content-filled additions that were in Battlefront 2015 is that those changes to the game were included with a season pass that cost almost as much as the base game. I think that seeing recycled maps and modes being added to the game is a worrying sign, and one that may point to there not being any major additions coming to the game. I do believe that new modes could help the game stay fresh though. I would also love to see a classic mode added to the game. Uncharted featured a mode similar to this where it takes out all abilities and has every player starting off with only a primary and a secondary weapon, as well as a throwable explosive. I think that Uncharted 2 and 3 even simplified it more with everyone only having an AK-47, a certain pistol, and a grenade. I hate the blue, purple, etc. color star card system and would love to just see an even battle in the game. The simplified combat of Ewok Hunt is so refreshing, it makes me wonder how better Battlefront 2 could be if it decided to drop the star card variety. Having a mode where all of the cards are turned off could be fun as well. I still stand by the belief that the star card variety was only introduced as a way to get players to pay real money for these cards. Since this isn't an option anymore, why not simplify the system? Maybe only have the base cards or just one extra tier like in Battlefront 2015. This would also help with balancing the game. Showcasing added content to the game is important as well. A large amount of players are wanting additional Clone Wars and prequel content added to the game. I am all for new content, but if the glaring problems that are already in the game aren't addressed, then new content will not have a strong foundation to build upon. New maps, heroes, weapons, and star cards and other additions may only introduce more problems rather than revitalize the game. Take Ewok Hunt for example. I consider this mode its own thing and has little to do with any of the other game modes or gameplay other than the base trooper combat. I think it works well because it isn't reliant on a majority of the other gameplay elements of the base game. There isn't a point system, there aren't star cards, and there are only a handful of abilities and weapons spread out across both sides. Some of these abilities aren't even in the base game and were created specifically for Ewok Hunt. If there are to be additional gameplay changes, such as more star cards added to the already flawed modes and gameplay designs of Galactic Assault and other modes, then there will only be more issues than solutions. I hope that the new Battlefront 2 announcement isn't just more stuff, but is instead a dedication to improving the quality of the game. If more stuff can be added on top of an improved game, then I'm definitely all for that. I am just fearful for the future of the game and am afraid that EA Play may be the last we ever hear of the game, especially with Battlefield 5 quickly approaching release. But improving Battlefront 2 can be a great way for EA to show that they are listening to the customers and are working on fixing the problems in their title. I guess we will find out Saturday if this will be the case. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, let me know what you think would help Battlefront 2 and, you know, whether or not you think that the game is gonna, you know, live or die. I am very hopeful that EA Play will show some really cool stuff for the game and, you know, I hope that they kind of take the approach of like, hey, we know the game's messed up and we messed up and, you know, not only is Battlefield 5 gonna have tons of new awesome changes, but you know, Battlefront 2 is going to be fixed as well. So I hope they do that. I just really doubt they will. EA kind of has the tendency to just kind of forget their mistakes and then move on to something else and be like, oh, we're going to improve with this thing. So I'm hoping that won't be the case, but we'll see, especially with Anthem and Battlefield 5 probably going to be pushed really hard. I'm a little fearful for Battlefront 2, but again, like I said, we'll see. So thank you so much for watching and I will see you all in the next video. Bye guys.